question, that it's a mixture of question. It's a kind of a question, because what you said now came to my mind, a kind of, let me explain where the question comes from. When I was giving a talk to the Third Moon Science, like 3 months ago, a medical doctor, which is a friend of mine from the University of L'Aquila, he's a medical doctor. He does not work with mathematical models. So I would like to ask you to, I respond to him with my experience. Now I want to ask you to respond to him with your experience. He asked me like this: suppose that a mathematical model make a mistake. Who will be responsible for the mistake? Because it's about artificial intelligence. Maybe the future of the model is going to help the medical doctor. But what about if the model makes a mistake? Can you maybe that's a big fear to use model, because you don't have legislation for mistake of a model.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah. It's a very interesting thing, because of course if doctor makes mistakes, it's one doctor, you can blame him. But if now somebody did not quote something,
it's random, what did that?
Because it will be distributed then responsibility. Like because knowledge now, it doesn't, that for example, one doctor, he accumulate all knowledge. But now let's say the computer model, the virtual human, will accumulate knowledge of all society together. And it's mean also that mistake would be distributed between all people who provided experimental information, who did coding, who designed this model. I think, yes, it would be no probably single person.
Would you agree with me? I said that to him. I don't know if you agree with me. Do you agree with me that nowadays you don't have a strong discussion about that? I mean, I believe you should discuss more about that, because we do our models, but you are not talking about the responsibility. For example, if a medical doctor uses your model, I believe you are not talking about that. I mean, in a serious way, like who's going to be responsible? Nowadays you have the agency that is able to judge if a medication is good or bad. But what about in the future, we have an agency that is where we make a protocol to say this model is reliable, you can use this model. So this is the protocol to use this model, this is the model, like you do with drugs, like you do with experiment. So far, I don't think that you have protocols. Do you have protocols? I don't know. I think you are like a little bit lost with models. Just make the models.
It should be. And one nice thing in models, that if there is a mistake, then this mistake can be really identified and later can be taken into account not to make it second time. But if we talk about single doctors, okay, perhaps the same mistake happens, let's say, several times. One doctor made mistake, and in another country, several years later, another doctor can make again the same mistake, and it will not learn from this mistake. But model, in principle, we can learn. And we can correct them something if we see that, okay, our prediction was wrong. And what also Hans, I see, he is saying some comments that complex models need to be tested to reduce the number of errors, of course. There will always be errors in them. We know this from the software industry, of course, yes, but it's always errors, yeah.
But I think the question of this professor from the University of L'Aquila, Professor Maggio, I think his question is because we don't have yet, for example, if you use a drug, and this drug, for example, I love medical doctor series. I like Dr. House, I love Grey's Anatomy, I love Dr. House the most. But as you see there, of course, that's a fiction. If they make a mistake, but the mistake is under protocol, they have no punishment. But if they make a mistake, the mistake is not under protocol, the punishment is bigger. So suppose that a medical doctor wants to be a revolutionary, Dr. House of the future, wants to use model. So he's able to see Alexei, Professor Hans, go there, Professor Hans, please give me a model. So he said to use the model, his model, the patient. But yeah, unfortunately, something goes wrong. The medical doctor will be responsible, I guess.
Of course, he always can say that my predictions are based on the model which I got, so I'm not responsible. Yes, the same like protocol. If he used some protocol, he knows that, okay, you should give aspirin in this case, and then he gave aspirin and then person died, and because of his very individual gene combinations. And the same can happen with model. I think it's referring to model like similar to protocols or not?
Yes, I thought about protocol, because when you do a protocol, you know precisely what to do. I mean, if you have to do this, you have to do that, it's a protocol. Like in Brazil, the vaccine has to be approved by Anvisa. So why it has to prevent Visa? Because Visa gives you a protocol that you have to apply this amount, you have to apply this, you cannot apply this way. So you know if you make a mistake, you have a protocol. You follow the protocol, so the problem is not mine. I mean, I made a mistake, but I follow the protocol. In the case of a model without protocol, it's if the medical doctor, because the point is like this. There is a very nice talk from Daniel Kahneman. Daniel Kahneman, he's a premium Nobel. I love his book. He wrote a book about noise, and I saw his talk. His talk, he was talking about the difficulty of, you said about that you trust you. You said like this, I prefer to trust artificial intelligence in the future than a doctor. I agree completely. But for example, he said about emotion. His book is about noise with emotion. It's true that a medical doctor can make much more mistake because of emotion, because of noise, and artificial intelligence. But I guess we still have a long way to make the model like reliable, like people start to trust. Like even today is difficult because sometimes people say it's afraid. Like I trust people more than I trust model. But you know that model in some cases better than human. But I guess one of the biggest difficulty will be to teach the society, the medical doctor, the society. You gave the example of the vaccine in Russia. It seems that some people are afraid to take the vaccine. It's not a matter that the vaccine is not safe. It's a matter of public opinion. People are afraid. So we know that if you not change people's mind, even the model, the best model for the world, people are not going to use the model. So I guess one of the biggest challenges is not about the right model. It's about changing people's mind, the culture, and so on, I guess. I don't know if it makes sense to you.
It makes sense, but still I think, for example, if you talk about vaccine and models, that if people would get a model for them saying, okay, that you have 0.01 chance of complication after vaccine and you have, let's say, 5% chance to die from the disease, they would go more for vaccination. But now they don't have this model and they have just opinions of some people whom they trust and don't trust. So they see that somebody in news said, oh, model, let's say vaccination can kill you, and then people believe, because also they don't have real numbers and they don't have computation. I think actually this, for example, model for vaccination, especially personalized maybe model, that people put his genome and then model say, okay, how much chance for him to get complication and how much for him to chances to be, let's say, protected from COVID. It would help to increase actually percentage of vaccinated people.
Okay.
Did you like the content of this channel? So please subscribe to the channel. It's quite simple. Just have to hit subscribe, and you can decide which level of the notification you want. You may choose all the notification. It means that everything that I do, you receive a notification on your bell here on the upper corner. Or you can choose no notification. I would strongly recommend you to subscribe, even if you don't wanna receive all the notifications. Just hit here, no notification, or hit the one that you like the most. It's pretty important that you subscribe to the channel so I can achieve a high number of subscribers, and people can as well understand that this channel has a nice content to offer, and YouTube will understand as well that it can make a nice divulgation of the channel. So please subscribe to the channel.